Hello and welcome back to the channel. In this tutorial, I will demonstrate how to use the Transform tool to enhance any of your already existing digital paintings. In 2021, I created a series of 6 videos showing all options and buttons that the tool offers. The tutorials are a little old, but I believe they are still relevant today. If you're interested to watch these videos, I'll add all the links in the description box. Let's get started. To illustrate the process, I've created this little chibi Eeyore. I'll work on the copied layer. This way, when I'm done, I can compare the before and after results. So let's start by activating the Transform tool. In the Tool Options Docker, you will find 6 options. The Free Transform option, the Perspective Transform option, Warp, Cage, Liquify, and the Mesh. I am going to start with the Mesh option. As you may already know, additional rows and columns can be added as needed. However, for the purpose of this simple demonstration, I'll only use the default configuration. Use the Mesh tool to stretch or compress your paintings. Now be careful though. If you go too fast, you may distort your art. If this happens, no worries. You can always undo any of your actions by simply pressing the Ctrl plus Z functionality. The only thing I really want you to remember today is to go slow. Go slow and make little, slight changes. When you are happy with your first modifications, click Apply or hit Enter on your keyboard to validate the changes. Let's move on to the Liquify option. When you select this option, a few buttons appear in the Tool Options Docker. Today I am interested in the top 2 buttons. This button is the Scale button. It allows you to grow or shrink anything under the cursor. The other button is the Move button. This one allows you to drag parts of your design. I'll start with the Move button. First, I need to modify the size of my brush. I cannot use the usual size slider located on the top of the interface. To modify the size of a transform brush, I need to use this size slider. Here again, take your time. Change the size of the brush as needed and move parts of your design very slowly. Hit Apply when done. I'll finish this tutorial with a Grow button. Same thing here, go slowly and adjust the size of your brush as needed. And just like earlier, make slight adjustments to not distort or damage your design. And we are done. Here is the before and after. I hope you can really see the potential of this tool when used properly. It can really do wonders. Thanks for watching. I will see you next time. Au revoir et à bientôt.